changes are long-term change in average weather conditions, including temperature, precipitation, and wind, as a result of greenhouse gases being polluted into the atmosphere. Climate change is being driven by carbon dioxide, which is being polluted into the atmosphere by people. Thus, it is clear that climate mitigation is needed in Japan to curb any other issues that could arise because of climate change. The strategies will take the form of wedges, from the stabilization triangle created by Stephen Pakala and Robert H. Sokolow of Princeton University. The triangle will have 8 wedges, each of them representing a carbon cutting strategy for Osaka, Japan, and possibly the world. Let me first introduce Japan and Osaka. Japan is an island country in East Asia, located in the Pacific Ocean. With a population of approximately 127 million, it is prone to natural disasters, especially ones that are caused by seismic activity and typhoons. Osaka is a city in the Kansai region of Japan. With an estimated 2.8 million inhabitants, it is situated at the mouth of the Yodo River on the Osaka Bay. Current issues that have arisen due to climate change is the poor air quality in Japan and the rising sea levels off the coast of Osaka that are making it even more vulnerable to climate change. I will now be focusing on the wedge strategies for Japan, Osaka, and the world. The first wedge. Carbon capture storage electricity. Install CCS at coal-fired plants in Osaka, Japan. Japan is currently in an energy crisis, as it needs to produce more electricity while it has shut down some of its nuclear power stations as a result of the Fukushima disaster. It also has carbon reduction commitments with other G7 nations, thus it cannot continue to build coal-fired plants and have them operate in a highly polluting manner that they have always operated in. Therefore, carbon capture storage systems must be installed at the current coal-fired power stations in Japan if these stations are not going to be removed for natural gas purposes. CCS storage can be done in Japan because the facilities are already available in Japan to do this, as they have been carrying out tests on CCS and the disposal of the pollutants created by CCS at the Mikawa power station, which is located in the southern coast of Japan. These tests could be carried out in Osaka, which is also located on the coast of Japan. CCS does have some drawbacks. For example, the concern that the stored carbon could leak out, it's expensive to run, which will result in communities paying more money, and currently the deployment of CCS projects is taking too long to have any real effect in decreasing carbon emissions of Japan and the world within the next 50 years. In order to achieve one wedge, the world will need to apply CCS to 800 large baseload coal power plants and 1,600 large baseload natural gas power plants in the next 50 years. Wedge 2. Install CCS and natural gas plants, CCS hydrogen. There is already a large market for natural gas production and purchasing in Japan. For example, the Osaka gas plant and other examples such as the Tokyo Gas Co. The increased availability of natural gas around the world is leading to its worldwide expansion. Japan is the world's largest importer of liquefied natural gas. Osaka Gas is Japan's second largest city gas supply. CCS is currently not fully operational at a commercial scale anywhere in the world. It is also not really geologically sound for Japan to dispose of the carbon pollutants under its ground, as it is prone to natural disasters such as earthquakes. Now to focus on my third wedge, wind-powered electricity. Wind-powered electricity contributes a total of 1% of the world's electricity, but it is important to note that it is growing at a rate of 50% per year. Wind energy does represent itself as a good option to tackle issues such as a lack of energy supply and poor air quality because of energy production. These issues currently affect most of the world and especially Japan and Osaka. Wind turbines would occupy about 50 million hectares of area, some of it being on land and offshore. Because windmills are widely spaced, land with windmills can be used for multiple purposes such as planting crops. Japan has the world's sixth largest sea space, therefore theoretically offshore wind power potential of wind power turbines is currently more developed and lower costing than floating wind turbine technology. But fixed bottom wind turbines are located close to shore. Locating turbines close to shore can cause many problems, such as a visual impact and even a negative impact on local population's fishing activities. And the strongest wind sources for wind power is located further away from shore, adding to the cost of the production of a possible wind turbine plantation and decreasing the potential of wind power if all of your wind power turbines are located close to shore. Wind power is a viable option for energy production in Japan. It is even being tested at this current moment as Japan has offshore wind projects within 500 meters of the coast, 4 to 5 meters deep water, and they have two offshore projects located over 2 kilometers away from the shoreline, which sit at 12 to 14 meters deep in water. Which can be achieved for wind turbines through the substituting of wind power for 700 gigawatts that are produced for coal and 1400 gigawatts that is produced for gas. I will now move on to my fourth wedge, which is solar electricity. Solar power works through photovoltaic cells that convert sunlight to electricity. It is carbon-free and renewable energy. This is important for the city of Osaka to help provide sustainable energy strategies to help cut its carbon emissions. Certain areas in Japan have the potential to produce 50 gigawatts an hour and 120 gigawatts an hour over the period of a year. The land that is required to produce the amount of solar energy for the world is less than that required by other renewable energies. Solar power, though, has some negatives compared to certain fossil fuels. For example, solar power needs direct sunlight to work and is optimal. It does not work well in cloudy or cold weather, and it works best when it receives direct sunlight. A wedge for solar power can be achieved through the replacing of 700 gigawatts of coal power and the equivalent of 1400 gigawatts of power produced from natural gas. Which I will be focused on nuclear power. Increasing the use of nuclear energy could act as a strategy to cutting carbon emissions in Japan. In 2011, a tsunami hit Japan, which was caused by an earthquake. The tsunami killed 19,000 people and resulted in the reactor core meltdown of the Fukushima nuclear plant. This meltdown caused a displacement of thousands of people as radiation was absorbed into waters and soils. Soon after this, public protests started and nuclear power plants were closed in Japan. Japan currently has 42 reactors that are operational or could restart. 24 of these reactors are in the process of restart approvals. Reducing nuclear power capacity is not sustainable. If this was done at a worldwide level, then not half of which would be added to emissions. The goal here is to decrease emissions, not add to them. Thus, the shutting down of nuclear power plants needs to be halted in Japan and the world. Better planning is needed, especially in areas like Japan, which is prone to nuclear disasters. For example, the Fukushima reactor, which had a meltdown after the tsunami hit, was well equipped to deal with earthquakes but not tsunamis. If it was better equipped to deal with tsunamis, then the reactor might not have had a meltdown, and these people would not have been displaced. If your plans had incorporated this into the Fukushima design, the reactor might not have meltdown. Building more nuclear reactors would result in there being more plutonium in the world's current stock. The world would need to triple its current nuclear capacity to cut emissions by one wedge. I will now be focusing on my sixth wedge, which is efficiency of buildings and transportation. More efficient buildings are needed in Osaka, Japan. Some of the new buildings in Osaka have energy-saving power generators on top of their roofs, but this is needed in the older communities as they make up more of the population. The more efficient use of electrical appliances would also count as energy-saving in Osaka, Japan and the world. Air conditioning in the cities is also needed to be monitored. Energy-saving lights could also be used in buildings and in homes. By cutting emissions of all existing and new buildings, similar coal electric power plants. The eighth of which, biofuels.
With the biofuel to account for 1/8 of emission savings, the current production of methanol will have to be increased 12 times. Many hope that biofuels can be used to solve the current emissions in spread the world, because biofuels are carbon neutral. The CO2 that is released in a biofuel is called subsoil renewable coal. Researchers in Japan are working to make biofuel from food plants and inedible parts of food crops. For example, an inedible part of a food crop would be the rice straw, which is a leaf and then burn part of a rice or food. The Ministry of Japan has provided funding to help with the research of turning these straws and wheat straws into biofuel.